Yes, I think you agree.
Okay.
Yes. This is for solar energy.
Yes, it is my first time attending a Model G20 summit. I feel really good about it. It's been a really positive experience.
So I used to do a bit of Model UN, and
I believe the structure of the MUN is different from the MJ20.
It's different because you have 20 different nations coming together, rather than a whole bunch of other nations just, you know, working together on small solutions, right?
And only one person represents the country, while in the MJ20, multiple people represent the country. In the MJ20, it's actually a good way to get people to work together as teams and collaborate.
And that's the major difference. And I think I prefer this one more because we have a common goal, which is to achieve sustainability. We negotiate and make deals. Like, we're trying to compromise instead of actually debating on something and trying to know who's right, who's wrong. And we're discussing a method or a certain way that helps us to do so. So it's very interesting.
Yes!
All right, good.
The most fun deal was the one that I was working on with the Netherlands about the Wageningen University Initiative.
The Sustainable Agricultural League. Because we want to use sustainable energy, we want to prevent climate change from happening. So
I've collaborated with a bunch of countries, especially the ones in lead in the car industry, and where we're just trying to be able to make electric cars more accessible for the poor and the rich.
And we're making deals about solar panels. We're trying to achieve probably 25% of our energy sources to renewable energy.
The two main deals we made is the solid oxide fuel seal, and this, another one is about global women education. And the global women education, every country signed it. So we're really happy. Yeah.
I'm going to prove to you. See?
Explain to me, what is it?
Many countries signed it.
So before the summit, I didn't know that women played such a big role in climate change. That when we educate our women and we give them the right to a choice, that plays the biggest impact on our society. Not only giving them basic education that a lot of countries lack, but rather giving them a seat at the table. Like, we want to show women that their opinions matter.
Country strategy sessions can be chaotic. I think one of the ambassadors said that before, that it's like good chaos. You know, everyone's kind of running around and trying to figure out what to do and who to talk to. It's almost like an adrenaline rush. It's like, oh my God, now we have to go here and talk to this person and this person. So that for me is really fun because
it was strategic, but we had one of the camera guys like go in and break apart their thing. They were in the middle of a discussion and they were about to sign. And like, we didn't want them to sign. We got the camera guy to pull out Brazil to take pictures, and then me and Cameron swooped in and we got our deal, so.
The most outstanding part of the summit so far is probably just how well people that are so different have been able to interact with each other, being able to make friends with people that are so different from you. And it really does bring out the best in you because people appreciate it.
My mind changed. It's like, if I don't came here, my mind wouldn't be like that broad, like that. It's like the experience you get here is nothing like what you learn in school.